Welcome class to the Math 1030 handout video for 6B, Measures of Variation. Why does variation matter in real life? We're going to take a look at an example of local pizza delivery times. Note that these times are invented. And then the neighborhood Pizza Hut has 10 delivery times here listed in this column. Okay. And if we inspect them visually for a little bit, we know that the numbers are really close to about 30 minutes. The neighborhood Domino's pizza place has these delivery times. There are 10 of them. And notice that the variation is a little bit higher because we have higher numbers in the 40s and 20s. So what is the mean for each of the pizza place's delivery times? Okay, let's start with Pizza Hut. If we add all of the numbers together, 30 plus 27 plus 33 plus 31 plus 28 plus 29 plus 30 plus 32 plus 29 plus 31, then we will be able to find the mean. We add them all up and we get 300. Like before, we said there was 300 numbers, so 300 divided, or 30, or 10 numbers, so 300 divided by 10 is equal to 30. So the average is, the mean is 30 minutes. For Domino's, we're going to add 30 plus 24 plus 40 plus 26 plus 34 plus 20 plus 40 plus 30 plus 29 plus 27, and we'll also get 300. 300 divided by 10 is equal to 30 minutes. So each of the pizza places' delivery times have a mean of 30 minutes. Even though 30 minutes is the same for each one, the difference in variation, or the numbers that are away from the mean, how far they are, does matter. Because if you're delivering pizza, or if you ordered a pizza, and you go with Domino's, you don't have any idea of when it will come. It will be, could be 20 minutes, or it could be 40 minutes. So that variation does set people on edge. If you go with Pizza Hut, they have a very consistent delivery time, around 30. And so that might be more comforting to those who want their pizza at a certain time. They can plan their evening. So does it matter? Well, a lot of people would say yes. Domino's has more variation. Okay, let's take a look at the variation, how spread the data is. Variation method number one is called range. What is the range for each pizza place's delivery times? Range means that we are going to take the highest number in the data set and subtract it from the lowest number. So for, as you can see for Pizza Hut, let's go down and look at the shortest time. The shortest time looks like it's 27 minutes. And let's take a look at the longest time, like 33 minutes. Okay. So for Pizza Hut, range, the shortest time, which is equal to 27 minutes. And we take the longest time, which is 33 minutes. and we subtract them. So the range is 33 minutes minus 27 minutes, and we get 6 minutes. So there's the range for Pizza Hut. For Domino's, the shortest time is equal to 20 minutes here. The longest time is the 40 minutes. So the range is 40 minutes minus 20 minutes equal to 20 minutes. Is this method for investigating variability reliable for all data sets? Why or why not? Okay, so we have the data set for Pizza Hut and Domino's. Now we have a couple of other pizza delivery companies and a couple of sets of times for them. Little Caesars has 5 times that they've delivered their pizzas, 2 for 20 minutes and 3 for 40. Papa John's is 30, 31, 33, 34, and 35. So let's take a look at the ranges of these. Let's see the range. This one, Little Caesars, you have the maximum 40, subtract the minimum 20, and that will give you 20 minutes. Okay, so the range for Papa John's, 35. Minutes is the max, minus 30 minutes, and that's going to equal 5 minutes. Okay, so those are the two ranges. So is this range a good indication of variability? Well, it doesn't look like it with our examples here. There are just 2 numbers in Little Caesars, yet it has the biggest range. There are 5 different numbers for Papa John's, yet the range is the smallest. So, in short, no. For example, we have 2 additional data sets here. The range for Little Caesars is larger, but doesn't have as much variation. So it's still good to know, because the range will help us in different types of measurements of variation, methods of measuring variation. So it's good to know this one. Okay. Variation method number two, the five number summary. The following are data for pizza delivery times that we have been using in the first part of our handout, but they're placed in numerical order. Okay, so we're doing the five number summary. The range is only two numbers, the largest and the smallest. But the five number summary can take three more numbers and give a better visual of the spread of the data, how much our data varies. So what is, and we're going to use that with the picture on the box plot down here later. So what is the median for each data set? Okay, so the five number summary begins with the median, begins with the range, but then also has the median next. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and calculate, find the median. So all of them have 10 data points, so we're just going to do crossing out as we get down to the middle ones, so 30 and 30. So then for the neighborhood Pizza Hut, the median is 30 minutes, because I found the middle. They're both the same number, so. And the neighborhood Domino's is this one. Halfway between those is 29.5 minutes. So here we have calculated the medians for the two data sets. Okay, this is where we're going to introduce now is the third number. Actually, this is the fourth number. It's called the lower quartile. Okay, so we have our range, which is our lowest value and highest value, our median. Okay, so that's the third number in our five number summary. The fourth is the lower quartile, and the fifth is the upper quartile. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and label our median in this data set. And that's right here in between these numbers. Okay. All right. Next, we're going to think about the lower quartile, which is if you take the lower half of the data, that's this part right here. Zoom in here a little bit. Okay, so we have our lower half, and I find the median of that lower half, that's the lower quartile. Okay, so we do not include the median in the lower half of our data. Okay, and so our lower quartile will be the median of it. So we're going to take crossings out. It happens to be this number right here. Okay, so this is the lower quartile, which is the median of the lower half of the data set. So for Pizza Hut and Domino's. All right, so have you identified that? So lower quartile is the division of the lowest fourth of the data set from the upper three fourths, okay? It's also the median of the lower half of the data set. Okay. So what is it for each set? Well, the lower quartile we did, see here. No, it's these ones, 29, 26. So for Pizza Hut, it's 29 minutes. And Domino's is 26 minutes. What does it mean by upper quartile? Well, as you may guess, the upper quartile is the division of the lowest 3/4 of the data set from the upper fourth. Also, you can think of it as the median of the upper half of the data set. Okay. So let's take a look at our data set and we're going to find the upper quartile. So we'll use our crossing off technique. Find that the upper quartile is here. Okay. It's in the middle. Okay, so those two numbers are the upper quartile. So with the each day set here, we have 31 minutes for Pizza Hut and 34 minutes for Domino's. Okay, so that's the median of the upper half of the data set. So our fifth number, so we have five numbers that can describe the spread of the data set. Again, those numbers are the lowest value, the lower quartile, the median, the upper quartile, and the highest value. Okay, so five numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We're going to draw a box plot, and this is a visual to see the spread of the data. So the first step in our box plot is we're going to label our axes. The bottom axis is the delivery time. In minutes. Okay. And so we have 0 minutes here for our first point, and we count off with 5. So 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45. Okay. So here's our delivery time. And we're going to have two rows on this, two boxes to compare. Okay. So the top row will be the Pizza Hut. And this one will be Domino's. Okay. To draw the box plot, we find each of the numbers. Okay. So the lowest value for Pizza Hut, let's go back up to our data here, is 27 minutes. Okay. The lowest value is 27 minutes. And let's go ahead and go to 27. And what we're going to do to plot this is we're going to draw a little tally mark. Tally mark just after the 25 right here. The lower quartile was Pizza Hut is 29 minutes, okay? So we have right before the 30, make another tally mark. The median was 30 minutes, so we'll put one at 30 minutes. The upper quartile was 31 minutes. And then the highest number, go up to here, was 33 minutes. So right before the 35. Okay, so we got five numbers, five tally marks, and you have to connect them in a certain way. First, you'll draw a line from the range, lowest value to highest value. Then you're going to connect the quartiles together, the third quartile. Sorry, the lower quartile and the upper quartile. Okay, and that creates the box. It's a box plot. Okay, so Pizza Hut, as we figured, the times were really, really close together. So the data didn't vary a whole lot. But with Domino's, we'll go ahead and see a little bit more of a variation. The lowest number for Domino's, let's go back up to our data, was 20 minutes. So I'm going to tally mark at 20. And Domino's row. Then the next one is the lower quartile, which is 26 minutes. So right after 25, we'll put another tally mark. The median was 29.5, so just before the 30. And the upper quartile is 34 minutes, but just before the 35. And the highest range was 40 minutes right there. So I have my five tally marks, and I'm going to connect the range, so lowest value and highest value. And then I'm going to connect the quartiles, the lower quartile and the upper quartile. Okay, and then we have our next box. Okay, so as you can see, the Domino's data is more spread. Let's go ahead and remind ourselves which ones of these are of the tally marks are which data point. So the first one is the lowest value. Oops, let's go ahead and put it in a different spot. Put it in a different spot right in front here. Yep, so that's the lowest value. This one is the lower quartile. This is the median. This is the upper quartile. And this is the highest value. Okay. Okay, so notice that the the box plots for the Domino's is a wider range. Okay. So it's spread more. You have more lower values and more higher values than Pizza Hut did. Okay. And that's good for, and that's for Pizza Hut's more consistent, and so a lot of people like that. Okay, so that's what a box plot is. And that's what the five-number summary is. Next, we're going to learn about standard deviation. Well, what is standard deviation? Standard deviation is a single number that is most commonly used to describe variation. It is a measure of how far the data values are spread around the mean of the data set. Okay, so that's what standard deviation is. A measure of how far data values are spread around the mean. So let's calculate the standard deviation for each of the pizza delivery sets. How far are they spread around the mean? Well, we have our box plot to give us an idea. that the standard deviation for Pizza Hut will be smaller than the standard deviation for Domino's, because the Pizza Hut data with the five number summary is closer together. Okay, so we have all of the data values listed in order for Pizza Hut delivery times in the first column, in this time column here. We're going to find first, to find the standard deviation, first we need to find the deviation. And the deviation means the time, subtract the mean, or the distance the time is away from the mean. Okay, so how far it deviates. So the first one we'll do is time, which is our 27 minutes, subtract the mean, which is 30 minutes. And what you have is a negative 3. Okay, so we're going to do that with all of our data points, keeping track of the negatives. I'm going to hold off on units for now, because what I'm going to do is I'm going to square and square the data deviations and square root them and so on. So we'll just kind of go with raw numbers for a little bit. And know that the deviation is going to be in the same units as time, as the data you start out with. So it will be a unit in minutes. Okay. All right, so we have 29 minus 30. Equals negative 1. Again, here's another 29. Here's a 30 minus 30, so that'll give us 0. Another 30 translates to another 0. 31 minus 30 is equal to 1. 31 minus 30 again, to 1. 32 minus 30 is equal to 2. And 33 minus 30 is equal to 3. Okay. So those are our deviations, negative 3, negative 2, negative 1, negative 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 2, 3. And we're going to go down to, and we're going to square these numbers to get the deviation squared. So negative 3 squared is equal to 9. Negative 2 squared is equal to 4. Negative 1 squared is equal to 1. Negative 1 squared again is equal to 1. 0 squared equals 0. 0 squared equals 0. One squared is equal to 1. One squared is equal to 1. Two squared is equal to 4. Three squared is equal to 9. Okay. After we square our deviations, we're going to add them together to get the sum of the deviations of them from the mean squared. And when I add them together, I am getting 30. So it's a coincidence that's 30. And it's not like that's the mean is the sum of the deviation squared. Now, we have a formula here that talks to that tells us how to calculate the standard deviation, okay? So we want to take the sum of the deviations from the mean squared divided by the total number of data values subtract 1. Okay, this is very important there. We have 10 data values, so we'll be dividing by 10 minus 1. And so to finish out the calculation, we're going to do the standard deviation, because that's what we're calculating. So the standard deviation is equal to the square root of 30, our sum of our deviations squared, divided by 10, the number of data points, subtract 1. And that's going to be the square root of 30 over 9, which is equal to about equal to 1.83 minutes. If I use my calculator. Okay. So the standard deviation is the square root of the sum of the deviations from the mean squared divided by the total values minus 1. All right, let's calculate the standard deviation for Domino's. Okay, we expect Domino's standard deviation to be bigger, okay, because the spread on the box plot is bigger. Okay, so let's do that one. 20 minus 30. Remember, the mean is also the same as it was for Pizza Hut. 20 minus 30 is negative 10. 24 minus 30 is negative 6. 26 minus 30 is negative 4. 27 minus 30 is negative 3. 29 minus 30 is negative 1. 30 minus 30 equals 0. And 34 minus 30 equals 4. 40 minus 30 equals 10. 40 minus 30 also equals 10. Okay, now we have our deviations from the mean. How the distance from the mean that they are. And we're going to square them. Negative 10 squared is 100. Negative 6 squared is equal to 36. Negative 4 squared is equal to 16. Negative 3 squared is equal to 9. Negative 1 squared is equal to 1. Zero squared is equal to 0. 2 squared is equal to 0. 4 squared is equal to 16. 10 squared is equal to 100. And another 10 squared is equal to 100. Okay, we're going to sum all of them up. And using our calculators, we can find that the sum is 378. Okay, so the standard deviation for dominoes is equal to the square root of 378 divided by 10, number of data values, subtract 1. Now it's important that we write 10 minus 1 here because we need to remember to minus 1 from our total data values. Subtracting 1 will give us a number that's closer to what we can see visually as far as the differences between each of the deviations from the mean. Okay. And so when we do that, we get 378 over 9, the square root of 378 over 9, which is approximately equal to 6.48 minutes, which is about 6.5 minutes. Okay. So as we inspect our deviations, we can see that 6.5 minutes is about kind of like the average or the common distance between the mean, okay? And so that's kind of what we are doing for standard deviation. And the standard deviation for the delivery times for each restaurant with each other in the five number summaries, as it says in part C, we're gonna compare them. So from that, we can see up here, five number summaries gives us this table here. Now Pizza Hut standard deviation, 1.83 minutes, and the standard deviation for Domino's was 6.48 minutes. Okay. And we can see that the 6.48 translates to a wider value, wider box plot, and then the 1.83, so it seems reasonable. Okay. So the standard deviations for delivery times for each restaurant, okay. So with Pizza Hut, Pizza Hut has a lower standard deviation which shows less variation, which we did see in our graph. Okay. So Domino's has a higher standard deviation. Which shows a higher variation. Okay, these are reflected in the box plot. Okay, so we can see that before. Now, the standard deviation is pretty complicated to calculate. And so what we're going to do is we're going to kind of, the book shows a couple of, shows a range rule of thumb, they call it, a way to approximate the standard deviation. And with that, you can even, there are also techniques to approximate the range. So let's start with the range rule of thumb, which this helps us do the approximating the standard deviation. All you have to do is take the range and divide it by 4. So with this one, we're going to approximate the standard deviation for, approximate the range for the neighborhood pizza at times. Okay, so our range to start out with for Pizza Hut, our range is 6 minutes. Okay. So that means that the standard deviation is about equal to the 6 minutes divided by 4. Okay, remember, range rule of thumb, divide the standard deviation by 4. Okay. And 6 divided by 4 is 1.5. About that. Okay, so how does that compare? How does that compare with the actual standard deviation? Okay, so we're going to go actual. Recall was 1.83 minutes versus our approximate, which was 1.5 minutes. And because of that, we can say that the approximation is actually really close. So approximation is pretty close. Okay, so that range rule of thumb works for finding the standard deviation of Pizza Hut. So we're gonna approximate the standard deviation for the neighborhood Domino's using this method as well. So the range for Domino's was equal to 20 minutes. Okay, so our standard deviation is approximately equal to 20 minutes divided by 4, which is equal to 5 minutes. Okay, so we're gonna box these. So we're going to approximate it using that and that. So how does this compare with the actual standard deviation? So the actual for Domino's was 6.48 minutes. We're going to compare that with the approximate, which is 5 minutes. Okay. So the approximate is not as close. This one. So we can say that the approximation is okay, but a little low. Should be higher. Now that's how I can approximate the standard deviation by using the range rule of thumb. We can also approximate the range by using the mean and the standard deviation. So the lowest value of the data set is approximately equal to, okay, so we're approximating the range. The lowest value is approximately equal to the mean subtract two standard deviations. So we're saying that the lowest value is approximately equal to the mean subtract two standard deviations. Okay. The highest value of the data set is approximately equal to the mean plus two standard deviations. Okay. So we can say that the highest value is approximately equal to the mean plus two standard deviations. Okay, now we're going to go ahead and approximate these delivery times using our data set. So first we'll start out with the shortest delivery time with Pizza Hut using the actual value. Okay, so the shortest time for Pizza Hut is going to be 30 minutes, which is the mean. Subtract 2 times the standard deviation, which was 1.83 minutes. So which is equal to 30 subtract 3.66, which is equal to 26.34 minutes. Okay, so there's our lowest value. Approximately the lowest value. So the actual, how does it compare? So the actual is 27 minutes versus the approximate at 26.34 minutes. Okay, so we say that the approximation is pretty good. Those numbers are close. Okay, so let's take a look at the approximate shortest delivery time for Domino's using this method. Okay, so we're going to go to Domino's, the shortest for Domino's. It's approximately equal to 30 minus 2 times the standard deviation, which is 6.48 minutes. Okay, so that's equal to 30 minus 12.96, which is equal to 17.04 minutes. Okay, so let's take a look at the shortest and the actual versus the approximate. So the actual shortest time is 20 minutes versus our approximate, which is 17.04. Okay. So with this approximation, it's okay, but it's a bit low. Domino's was never that fast. Okay. Let's go ahead and estimate the longest delivery time for the Pizza Hut using this method. So the longest time is approximately equal to the mean plus two standard deviations. So 2 times 1.83 minutes. Okay. So that's equal to 30 plus 3.66, which is equal to 33.66 minutes. Right. So our approximation, how does it compare with what really happened? So the longest for Pizza Hut was actually 33 minutes. Okay. So the actual was 33 minutes versus our approximate, which is equal to 33.66 minutes. Okay, so the approximate is good. Let's approximate the longest delivery time for Domino's. Okay, so the longest time for Domino's is approximately equal to 30 plus 2 times the standard deviation, which is 6.48 minutes, which is equal to 30 plus 12.96 minutes, 30 plus 12.96, which is equal to 42.96 minutes. Okay, so that's our approximation using our range rule of thumb. And so how does this compare to the actual highest value? Well, the actual was 40 minutes versus our approximate of 42.96 minutes, or actually really close to 3 minutes, or sorry, really close to 43 minutes. Okay, so the approximation is okay, not great, but a little high. So we can see that the higher the standard deviation, the more off our model is, our approximation. Okay, so that's our lesson on measures of variation. Let me know if you have any questions.